So, hello everyone. I'm Dr. Shobha Shankar, professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Vidyavartaka College of Engineering, Mysore. So, I'll be mainly covering Module 3 of Power System Analysis 2, that is, Economic Operation of Power System. So, today in this first session, I'll introduce you to the Economic Operation of Power System. So, I'll be sharing my slide or the screen. So this is what is covered in Module 3. So that is economic operation of power system or optimal system operation. So it has the following topics, namely introduction, optimal generation of generators on a bus bar, optimal unit commitment, reliability considerations, and optimum generation scheduling. So in this session, we will take up only the first part, that is introduction to optimal system operation or economic operation of power system. So economic operation of power system is also called as optimum generation scheduling or optimum system operation. So in the introduction, so we know that in the earlier applications of online centralized control, it was mainly to provide a central facility in order to ensure that the various generating plants which would supply for the loads in the system would operate economically. So we know that in the power system, there are various types of generating plants, such as thermal plants, hydro plants, nuclear plants, oil and natural gas, etc. So the investment cost, especially the capital investment and the operation and maintenance costs are different for the different types of plants, especially for a hydro plant. The operation cost would be minimum or otherwise negligible. It is not so for a thermal plant. So therefore, the investment cost, operation and maintenance costs are different for the different types of generating plants that are used for to generate the power. So in any power system, when we say economic operation, we are mainly interested to ensure that the cost involved in generating the power is minimized. And at the same time, the real power losses in the transmission lines is also kept at its minimum. So in the economic operation, which mainly involves economic, we are mainly interested in reducing the fuel cost of generating the power. And at the same time, we will ensure that the power losses in the transmission lines is also minimum. So in order to achieve economic operation, we need to ensure that a combination of power outputs for each generating units needs to be determined so that the total cost of generating the power and the power losses in the transmission network are minimum. What are the factors that influence the cost of generation? So the factors which influence are generator efficiency, fuel cost, and transmission losses. So let us assume that I am using a generator with a very high efficiency. That does not mean that just by using this generator with maximum efficiency will not ensure the cost of generating the power using this generator would be minimum. This is because this generator may be located in a place where fuel cost is very high. And further, we also know that the load centers are located far from the generator points, and therefore transmission losses would also be high, and running the plant may not be economical. So in economic dispatch or economic operation of power system, it mainly determines the generation of various plants to minimize the total operating cost. So here it does not include the startup cost or the shutdown cost or the capital investment cost or otherwise the maintenance and depreciation. All these are not included in the economic dispatch or the economic operation of the power plants. We are only interested in minimizing the total operating cost. So before we take up what is the condition for economic scheduling of generators, we will see the basic performance curves, especially for a thermal plant. So some of the performance curves for a thermal plant are, first one, input-output curve. So this is the fundamental curve for a thermal plant. So especially for a thermal plant, this is the fundamental curve, and it is a plot of input in British thermal unit, that is in BTU per hour, with respect to the power output in megawatt, as shown in this figure one. So this is exclusively a fundamental curve for a thermal plant, and it's a plot of input in British thermal unit per hour with respect to output in megawatt. Second, we have heat rate curve. Heat rate is defined as the ratio of fuel input in British thermal unit to the energy output in kilowatt hour. So heat rate is nothing but the ratio of the fuel input to the energy output, and the units would be in BTU per kilowatt hour. So it is also the slope of the input-output curve at any point. So the reciprocal of heat rate is called fuel efficiency, and the heat rate curve is a plot of heat rate, which is in British thermal unit per kilowatt hour with respect to output in megawatt. And the third curve is incremental fuel rate curve. The incremental fuel rate is equal to a small change in the input to the corresponding change in the output. So the unit is British thermal unit per kilowatt hour with respect to output in megawatt. So this is shown in figure three. And the last one, incremental cost curve. The incremental cost is the product of incremental fuel rate and fuel cost. So fuel cost is in terms of rupees per British thermal unit, and the corresponding curve is shown here. So the incremental cost, the units will be in rupees per megawatt hour with respect to output in megawatt. So this is the actual cost that is incurred, which is non-linear. And this non-linear cost can be approximated as linear, as shown in the dotted line. So these are the four performance curves with respect to a thermal plant. So in general, let us assume that if Fi is the fuel cost for a plant, it can be approximated as a function of generated output PGI. So it can be expressed as Fi is equal to Ai plus Bi PGI plus Ci PGI square. In the unit is rupees per hour, wherein PGI is the output of the generator and Ai, Bi, Ci are constants. So knowing the fuel cost function as a function of generated output PGI, we are able to express the incremental fuel cost as, so differentiating the above expression, we are able to express dFi by dPGI to be equal to Bi plus 2 times Ci PGI. Again, the units would be rupees per megawatt hour, or otherwise dollar per megawatt hour. So the incremental fuel cost, it is a measure of how costly it is to produce an increment of power. Let us assume that initially we had a load of PD megawatts, and let us assume that now the load is increased by a small increment. Because of this increment in the load, any one of the generator has to meet this additional increment in load. And let us assume that one of the generators would add an additional power output of that equivalent to the incremental load, then correspondingly that additional cost because of the additional increment in the load would be called as incremental fuel cost. And we also know that the generators in the power system need to be operated within the minimum and maximum limits. So the minimum limit is set based on the technical feasibility to operate a plant, and the maximum is based on the rating of the generator. So in this session, we have seen the introduction to optimum or optimal generation scheduling, or otherwise economic operation of power system. Thank you.